गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर। फाइन सर।
Aditya, what about rest of them, science students? Have they class at this time, Aditya?
Well, I don't know.
No? Do they have class in science class?
Sir, your voice is not audible.
Okay. Now is it? Hello? Hello?
That is quite low.
Quite late. Low.
Low, low. Yes, sir.
Low voice. Hello.
Yes,
Yes, sir.
yes,
Now audible.
Is it audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very clear.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. So, and the body is clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Whatever we read yesterday. Yes? Did you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very well. If you have done so, thank you very much. And those who have not done, they should. You must revise every day whatever we are reading in that classroom. So as we begin the chapter, let's first discuss the word of the day. What is today's word?
So king hit.
King hit. And the meaning of king hit is?
A sudden knockout blow.
A sudden knockout. A sudden punch. A sudden hit. Can we use it in the sentence? Any one of you? Can you use it? It is a noun. You can use it as a sentence. Any one of you?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
So your voice is very low.
Low to you or low to everybody? Tell me. For others, is it? What about others?
So we are also not audible.
One at a time. Yes.
So not audible.
Not audible means it is low voice or you cannot understand anything you can say.
Very low.
Very low.
Very low voice.
But just now it was coming all right. Just now I had asked you and you said it's okay.
Yes, sir, but just now it's very low.
Again. Hello. Now it is coming.
Yes, sir. हेलो
इट्स स्लो स्टिल
हेलो
चलो इट्स क्लियर टू मी बट आई डोंट नो व्हाई टू दिस
हेलो
यस सर
यस सर
सर अर्लियर इट वाज वेरी लो नाउ इट इज स्लो
नाउ इट इज
या
नाउ इट इज ओके और लोअर
इट्स लोअर
एंड अर्लियर इट वाज ओके
No, sir, it was very low.
And what about now?
Much better than previous, but not okay. so loud.
Now, okay, so so the word of the day is king hit, and the meaning is sudden punch or knockout. The chapter which we began yesterday, name of it is Divan, Rise, and O Level. And you know, Ivan is a prisoner. He had already escaped from the prison 3 times, and it was his 4th attempt. So he was planning to escape next time, and therefore he had thought of. appearing for an exam that is O level in German language. Now, if you talk about the characters of the chapter, so the characters, major character is Ivan, and then secretary of the board exam. Then there is governor. Governor is the supreme head or authority of the jail. He is a jailer also, you can say that. Next officer is Jackson, and after that Stephen. So all these are the characters, major characters you would notice in the chapter. Now the keywords which you are going to notice in the chapter which you shall read, that is number one is riveted. Riveted means to attach something or to fasten something, to tie something someone to. Next is peephole. Peephole has also got a synonym, that is spy hole. A small window attached in a door, especially of glass door, so that a person can keep an eye on one who is inside. Next is minister. Minister means a priest, a parson, a priest of the church. Next word is hostage, and the meaning of hostage is a person who is seized by someone for threat or security or some reason. Next is frisk, and the meaning of what frisk is to search someone, especially the policemen. They frisk the criminal, they frisk suspicious person. A quick recap up to where we left yesterday. So we had read, we had begun the chapter with the introduction of the story, with the summary of the story, and in the introduction of the story we came to know about the conversation between the secretary of board exam and the governor. Both of them were talking. The governor wanted to fix a date and the location for exam for only the student pass. So the secretary of board asked him about his character, behavior, his criminal record, and the governor said that he is not very violent and he keeps on signing during Christmas festival in the prison. So you need not worry about him. And the secretary of the board exam agreed to arrange the exam for him in the prison itself. He said that you could arrange the exam for himself in the prison. All the safety measures should be taken by you, and then it will be all right for him. So after the conversation, the governor ordered Jackson, the senior prison officer, and Stephen, both of them, to take all the precautions for the safety of one's exam. He was worried about escape of Ivan because Ivan was the jailbreak. He was given the name jailbreak. Jailbreak, why? Because he had already escaped from the jail 3 times and he was successful in his next attempt also. So Stephen and Jackson, both of them, they frisked Ivan's cell, they frisked his clothes, they frisked him, but they made some mistake. And because of that mistake, because of that ignorance, Ivan took advantage of the situation and Ivan escaped from the prison. Now, what are the mistakes made by the prison authorities? I have written it here on the board. Number one, when Jackson and Stephen early morning before the exam, when they went and checked Ivan's cell, they did not ask him to remove the cap. They had asked, but Ivan said, "It is my lucky charm. I please allow me." He begged, and Jackson, he had allowed Ivan not to remove the hat because under the hat he had trimmed hair like McLeary. It was a long pre-plan of Ivan and his friend to escape from the prison, and their plan was going very well. Another mistake they did, the prison authority did, was the teacher who used to come to teach them every day, he was never checked. His identity was never checked, whether he is a real teacher or somebody else in disguise of teacher. Next, McLeary, the parson, the priest, who was invigilator for Ivan's exam, when he came for taking the exam, his identity was not cross-checked. So they took him for granted that he is real McLeary, but actually it was Ivan's friend in disguise of McLeary the priest. And then reason of engagement of phone was not checked. Why the phone was engaged during the exam. Actually, it was the trick of Ivan's friend. They were using it. They were using the governor's number, governor's phone, and they had cheated the prison authority, that is Jackson and Stephen. Next mistake was re-arrest at Golden Lion Hotel, Newbury. So the governor had re-arrested Ivan at Golden Lion Hotel, but from there also he escaped. And how did he escape? It is, the reasons are written here. He escaped with the help of the teacher. The teacher was associated in complete planning. And the McLeary. The McLeary, why is the McLeary? Because McLeary was in, actual McLeary was tied up in his room. He was made hostage. And in get up of McLeary, somebody else had come. And he escaped using the imported clothes and blood, artificial blood. And this blood was made of using human blood and pig blood. Then there were other things also. He had brought the McLeary, the Minister McLeary had brought with him in the briefcase. And Ivan had managed his hair under the cap using scissors. He had trimmed his head. And final escape, when it was a final escape in the Golden Lion, the governor was shocked. The governor had called the police van. The police van came, but the governor did not check the van. The governor did not accompany the van to the prison, or he didn't cross-check whether the real policeman asked him there or somebody else. And this is how the prisoner, he wanted the governor. My voice is coming now, clear, all of you, or not?
Sir, it's very low.
It's very low, but you can hear, no problem. and it's low only for you. What about other statistics? Can you hear it clearly? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Chirag Meena?
Sir, it's very low. The voice is not clear.
Okay, very low for art students. Okay. Yes, what about Jayant Patidar? Jayant Patidar, are you there? Are you listening?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. My voice is reaching there in half an hour?
No, sir. It is very low.
But it is reaching or not? I asked, is my voice reaching? I did not ask whether low or
high. Yes, sir. It is reaching.
And are you able to understand what I am saying?
Sir, it's not audible.
Then how you are replying? I am talking to you and you are replying. How can you reply if you don't understand?
Sir, I am pressing my ears to listen to you.
Okay,
you are
observing my lips. So lips reading. Another skill you are learning.
No, sir.
Reading of the teacher. So very well, you can understand by reading my lips. Yes, Gracie, isn't it? Yes or no?
Yes, sir, might be possible.
Sahil, what do you say, Sahil Kashwani? Sahil is expert in reading lips, but he doesn't use his lips in saying any words. Hey, Sahil. Sahil is sleeping.
So your voice is very low, that's why they can't hear.
But I can hear you very clearly.
So because we are speaking so loud.
And I am also shouting here. I'm not speaking in low voice, rather I'm shouting. Might be the reason, I don't know.
And still we can't hear you.
So you can see the mic here. Can you see the mic here?
Yes, sir, we can see, but it's not audible.
It is not audible.
Now, should I keep like this? Now it is audible.
Yes, sir, now it's audible.
No, but in earlier also in all the class, I was keeping the mic here only.
Earlier in all the classes which have been conducted, I just kept the mic here. Now, I will have to keep the mic like this, I think. Yes, now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, we continue the chapter from where we left yesterday. Do you remember where we left yesterday? Which page number? Any one of you?
So page number 74,
we had finished, and now we shall begin from page number 75. So yesterday we read that before the exam, final checkup was done by Jackson. Jackson came to the cell and he told Evans to remove all the posters. So Ivan had put poster in the wall, on the wall of his cell, and the posters of some model, some actress. And Jackson said, the person who is coming, he's a minister, he's a priest, he's a God's man. And what kind of dirty poster you have put on the wall? Remove them, take them out. And he gave him final warning not to misbehave, not to use any unfair means. And he went away. Now, what happens? We shall read from page number 75. So, who is ready to read? Raise your hand. Okay. So, first hand, quick hand, Gracie Upadhyay. Yes, Gracie, read from page number 75. First line. Can I ask you something from here? Yes, begin.
Yes, sir. Can I ask you something? Mr. Jackson, why did they have to bug me in this cell? He nodded his head vaguely to a point above the door.
Okay.
Not a very neat job.
Just a minute. So he said, why did they have to bug me? Bug me means why they have to capture me in the cell. And why they have fixed this microphone in my cell, in the prison. What is the need of it? Yes, continue.
Not a very neat job. Considered Jackson. They don't honestly think I am going to try to. They are taking no chances, Evans. Nobody in his sense would take any chance with you.
So So Jackson said they are not going to take any chance with you. Everybody knows that you are a jailbreaker. You have already escaped from the jail 3 times. So the governor and all the authorities, they do not want to take any chance with you. Therefore, they have fixed all the safety measures, safety tools. Continue.
Who is going to listen in? I'll tell you who is going to listen in. Lady. It's the governor himself.
Laddie. Yes, 1 minute. Laddie. Laddie means chokre. L-A-D, lad. And the word has become laddie. So it is used for boy. Laddie means chokra, ladka. Yes, continue.
Yes, sir. It's the governor himself. See, he don't trust you a bloody inch. And nor do I. I'll be watching you like a hawk, Evans. So keep your nose clean, clear. He walked towards the door.
Yes, keep your nose clean. What does that mean? What is the meaning of this? Keep your nose clean. What phrase is this? Keep your nose clean. Yes? Behave properly. Don't use any unfair means. Don't try to act smart. That is the meaning of keep your hair. Yes? Keep your nose clean. Yes. Continue.
He walked towards the door. Evans nodded. He had already thought of that. And number 2 handkerchief was lying ready on the bunk. A neatly folded square of off-white linen. Just one more thing, Einstein. Yeah. Was at. Good luck, old son. In the Litton Lodge, just inside the prison main gates, a Reverend S. McLary signed his name neatly in the visitor's book and then walked side by side with a silent prison officer across the exercise yard to D Wing, where he was greeted by Jackson. The wing's heavy outer door was unlocked and locked behind them, the heavy inner door the same, and McLary was handed into Stephen's keeping. Get the razor, murmured Jackson. Stephen's nodded. Well, keep your eyes skinned. Clear? Stephen's nodded again. An ancillary, his feet clagging up the iron stairs, following his new guide, and finally stood before a cell door, where Stephen's opened the peephole and looked through. That's him, sir. Evans, facing the door, sat quietly at the farther of the 2 tables. His whole attention riveted to a textbook of elementary German grammar. Stephens took the key from its ring, and the cell lock sprang back with a thudded metallic twang.
Yes. So what happened now? After the safety and security of Evans' cell was checked, finally, the time had come when the invigilator McLary arrived. And when McLary arrived, he was also frisked. He was also checked. His things were checked, whether he has any unwanted things or not. So Stephen had frisked him, and he also saw there was a paper knife, there was church magazine, there was a rubber tube, and he asked about all these things. And the proper explanation was given by McLary. And then Jackson and Stephen, especially Jackson, murmured, get the razor, because he had left the razor for Evans' shaving. So Jackson reminded suddenly Stephen, and Stephen said, yes. And Jackson also said, well, keep your eyes skin clear. Keep your eyes completely open. And means to say, observe Evan. He may do anything wrong to escape from the prison. And Stephen nodded, yes, because Stephen was subordinate. Jackson was senior, Stephen was junior. Therefore, Jackson was commanding Stephen, and Stephen had to oblige. So Stephen opened the door, and he took McLary. After checking inside, there were 2 tables, 2 chairs, and everything was ready for the exam. Ivan, facing the door, sat quietly at the farther of the two tables, his whole attention riveted to a textbook of elementary German grammar. So he was trying to concentrate to that book. If he could get the book, it would be helpful for him. And then Stephen, after finally putting them inside, both of them, he took the key from its ring and he locked the cell. And now he came out, and time to time he was keeping an eye. He was coming out every after 10 minutes and he was peeping through the peephole and watching what was going inside. So everybody, all the prison authorities, Jackson, Stephen, Governor. Governor had already fixed the microphone in the Ivan's cell, and he was listening to everything which was going into the cell. Yes, continue, Gracie.
Yes, sir. It was 9:10 a.m. when the governor switched on the receiver. He had instructed Jackson to tell Ivan's of the temporary little precaution. That was only fair, as if Ivan's wouldn't spot it. But wasn't it all a bit theatrical? Schoolboyish almost. How on earth was Ivan's going to try anything on today? If he was so anxious to make another break, why in heaven's name hadn't he tried it from the recreational block? Much easier. But he hadn't, and there he was now, sitting in a locked cell. All the prison officers on the alert. Two more locked doors between his cell and the yard. And a yard with a wall as high as a haystack, yes. Haystack, yes. Ivan's was as safe as houses.
So when it was 9:10 a.m., the governor switched on the receiver. He switched on the receiver means he called to Jackson and he instructed Jackson to tell Ivan's of the temporary little precaution. That was only fair, as if Ivan's wouldn't spot it. But he also asked them to tell him to take all the safety measures and keep an eye. And Jackson for a moment thought that, is he going to do anything? Is he going to take any step so that the governor is much concerned about him? And he was satisfied that where Ivan's was sitting, where he was giving exam, his wall was as high as a haystack. What is a haystack? Haystack is a heap of the tall grass. Cordel. So that haystack, that long grass. Ivan was as safe as houses. Now, anyway, it wouldn't be any trouble at all to have the receiver turned on for the next couple of hours or so. It wasn't as if there was going to be anything to listen to, was it? Amongst other things, an invigilator's duty was to ensure that the strictest silence was observed. So the purpose of invigilator was that Ivan is not involved in any kind of unfair means. He is giving his exam seriously. There is no one who is disturbing him. Therefore, the governor had put the microphone. But still that little nagging doubt. And if there was anything nagging, anything troubling, it could be doubtful. Might Ivan's try to take advantage of McClary? Get him to smuggle in a chisel or two, or a rope ladder, or so governor was still thinking. He was much conscious about Ivan, and he was thinking, can he blackmail McClary? Can he take advantage of McClary? He can ask him to smuggle him a chisel. What is chisel? To break the stone, a tool used to break the stone, to break the rocks. It is beaten by hammer. So he could ask him for a rope, ladder. So it was only going on in his mind. Yes. So it all these things shows that the governor was very much conscious, anxious, careful about Ivan's and his safety. Yes, continue.
The government sat up sharply. It was all very well getting rid of any potential weapon that Ivan's could have used. But what about McLary? What if, quite unwittingly, the innocent McLary had brought in something himself? A jackknife, perhaps? And what if Ivan's held him hostage with such a weapon? The governor reached for the phone. It was 9:12 a.m. The examinee and the invigilator had already been introduced by Stephens when Jackson came back and shouted to McLary through the cell door, "Can you come outside a minute, sir?" "You too, Stephens." Jackson quickly explained the governor's worries, and McLary patiently held out his arms and at shoulder level, whistled Jackson lightly frisked his clothes. "Something hard to hear, sir."
"My reading glasses," replied McLary, looking down at the spectacle case. Okay, so the governor was conscious, worried, as we have discussed earlier, and therefore he had again called to Jackson. Jackson was the senior prison officer, and he had instructed Jackson to check, to frisk McLary. And before the exam started, they were already introduced. It was introduced that this is your invigilator and this is your examinee. And both of them were in the cell. Who both? McLary and Ivan. So now when the exam was about to begin, Jackson came and he shouted. He called McLary. He said, "Just a minute, sir. Could you please come out for 2 minutes? And McLary, along with Stephen, came out. And when he came out, he was frisked. His clothes were searched. His pocket was searched. Everything was searched. And they found something hard. And they asked, "What is it, sir?" And McLary said that, "This is my glass. These are my spectacles." And now furthermore things would be found. Yes, continue.
Jackson quickly reassured him. And bending down on the landing, thumb flicked the catches on the suitcase. He picked up each envelope in turn, carefully passed his palms along their surfaces, and seemed satisfied.
Now he opened the suitcase. Now Jackson took the suitcase and he opened the suitcase, and whatever the envelopes and things he found, he opened it one by one. Continue.
He refilled cursorily through a few pages of Holy Writ and vaguely shook the Church Times. All right, so far. But one of the objects in McLary's suitcase was puzzling him sorely. "Do you mind telling me why you have brought this, sir?" He held up a smallish semi-inflated rubber ring, such as a young child with a waist of above 12 inches might have struggled into. "You thinking of going for a swim, sir?"
Okay, so, so when Jackson checked his things, he asked him the explanation. But one thing he found different, that was the tube, a ring. And he asked, "Could you please tell me, sir, why have you brought this ring, this tube? Do you want to go for swimming? But this ring is sufficient only for a small boy. He could only swim using this ring. Can you please explain why you have brought this rubber ring?" And McLary explains why he has brought that rubber ring. Continue.
McLary's hitherto amiable demeanor was slightly ruffled by this tasteless little pleasantry, and he answered Jackson somewhat sourly, "If ye must know, I suffer from hemorrhoids.
Yes.
Hemorrhoids. And when I'm sitting down for any length of time."
Okay, so McLary, who so far was behaving properly, demeanor means good behavior. So McLary, hitherto amiable, amiable means loving nature, amiable means loving, admiring, and demeanor means behavior, conduct. So McLary, who so far was showing good behavior, he was slightly ruffled. He was cruel by this tasteless little pleasantry, and he answered Jackson sourly, means cruelly. He answered, "You don't know why I have brought it. So If you want to listen, you listen that I have brought it because I am suffering from hemorrhoids. What is hemorrhoids? It is a disease, and in simple language, you could call it piles. Now all of you understand what is hemorrhoids, what is pile. So he said, I find it difficult to sit longer on a chair or on any hard surface. Therefore, I use it for sitting. Continue.
Very sorry, sir. I didn't mean to. The embarrassment was still reddening Jackson's cheeks when he found the paper knife at the bottom of the case. I think I better keep this though, if you don't mind. That is, sir. It was 9:18 a.m. before the governor heard their voices again, and it was clear that the examination was going to be more than a little late in getting underway. McLary, you've got a watch? Evans, yes, sir. McLary, I'll be telling you when to start, and again, when you have 5 minutes left, or right. Silence. McLary, there's plenty more of this writing paper should you need it. Silence. McLary, now write the name of the paper 0211 in the top left hand corner. McLary, in the top right hand corner, write your index number 313. And in the box just below that, write your center number 271. All right.
So 9:18, the exam started, and McLary is giving instruction to Ivan. He asked first, do you have a watch? And Ivan said, yes, sir, I have. And now McLary is giving instruction to Ivan how to write roll number, how to write index number, all those things. Yes. And it was silence. So why it is written silence? Because only when McLary and Evans were speaking, the governor was hearing their conversation, their voice through the microphone. Whereas when they were not speaking, it was silent. So it was silent at 9:20 a.m. McLary, I am now going to. So McLary said, I am now going to start the exam. Evans, as not going to stay here, is it? So Ivan thought that he is not going to stay here. He would just leave Ivan alone in the cell and he would go. McLary said, I don't know about that. I don't know whether I should stay here or no. I have not been instructed. Stephen, Mr. Jackson, give me strict instruction too. So Stephen said that Mr. Jackson has given me clear instruction to remain here. So Ivan had objected to it. Ivan said that why Stephen is here? When my invigilator is here, he shouldn't be here because it is troubling me. And Ivan said, how am I supposed to concentrate on my exam when this fellow is standing here with someone breathing down my neck? Christ, sorry, sir, I didn't mean it. So Ivan said, I cannot concentrate in my exam if Stephen is going to.
Yes, sir. The governor reached for the phone. Jackson? Ah, good. Get Stephens out of that cell, will you? I think we are perhaps overdoing things. As you wish, sir. The governor heard the exchanges in the cell, heard the door clang once more, and heard McLary announce that the examination had begun at last. It was 9:25 a.m. and there was a great calm. At 9:40 a.m., the examination board rang through and the assistant secretary with special responsibility for modern languages asked to speak to the governor. The examination had already started, no doubt. Ah, a quarter of an hour ago. Yes. Well, there was a correction slip which some fool had forgotten to place in the examination package. Very brief. Could the governor please? Yes, of course. I'll put you straight.
Wait. So exam started at 9:25 a.m. and there was a great calm. There was a complete silence. The exam started. And after 15 minutes at 9:40 a.m., the examination board rang through, and